και πάλι μαζί.
Being in the zone is like no other feeling in this world. Your hands are very numb. You get chills going up through your whole body. It's just you in the basket.
He is something to watch.
You feel like you're unstoppable. Anything you throw up is going to go through the net.
He is on fire.
It started when you picked up your first ball. You were learning. Learning how to dribble, how to shoot. But there was more. Things that weren't as much fun, but just as important. Things that made a difference. You learned so much about this game. You even learned to love it. And just when you thought you knew it all, you learned a little more.
Celtics with a shot, and I got my chance.
Once you take off,
You don't know how far you are away from the basket. You just know I can take off.
Just explode. Try to get up as high as you can, and sometimes feel like you're in slow motion.
It's quiet all the way to the basket. It's effortless.
And once you're up there, you have enough time to think about what you're going to do.
I just want to keep going until I reach the top.
You're going up and the defender jumps with you. You have to go over him. Simple as that.
When Phil drew up the play at the end, everybody in the gym, everybody on TV knew it was coming to me.
It is Michael Jordan time.
I looked to Steve and I said, hey, this is your chance. And he said, he's giving me the ball.
He comes off. I'll be ready.
Hand back Jordan. Here's six on the shot. Jordan keeps the dribble. Jordan fights. Jordan hits Kerr. Kerr, 85 yards.
Then I passed him the ball and he knocked the shot down. And I'm very happy for Steve Kerr.
When you first step on the court, it's like being on stage. It's hard to describe, but you know, it's the adrenaline running inside of you. It's one of those unique feelings.
You're out there, you're playing, you're focused, thinking about what you have to do. But the minute that you have to come off the floor, the minute that you have to miss a game for an injury, you realize, yeah, I love the game of basketball.
I just love to be out there and perform for people. Just showing people something special. But the only thing that really matters is the love of the game, because the game is sacred.
Showtime.
Nobody brings teens the excitement of the NBA like TV's Inside Stuff.
You gotta check that out, man.
Now NBA Inside Stuff magazine brings teens exclusive behind-the-scenes stories and original photos not available anywhere else. Call 1-800-NBA-STUFF or log on to NBA.com to order NBA Inside Stuff magazine. Follow all your favorite players with Inside Stuff, the NBA's official teen magazine. So call this toll-free number and say, I want the Inside Stuff.
I believe in history. Now, I'm a part of history. If the average fan today could see some of the moves of Elgin Baylor and Connie Hawkins, then they would say, whoa. I've seen those things before. A great many, many, many times. It was somewhere magical. And the fans should know that it isn't just being done today, it had been done yesteryear.
Shamiqua Holzclaw. My development of the game probably started when I was like 11 years old, you know, doing my thing, going behind the back, shooting the fadeaway jumpers. 7 championships in a row from high school through college. I'm really like a laid-back person, and I like to shop, of course. I have over 300 DVDs. I watch a lot of movies. Scarface, definitely. The Godfather series. You talking to me? Be patient. It will happen. Do you have faith? This is who I am. I am Shamiqua Holzclaw.
Talk. A look inside the NBA coach's playbook.
Hi, I'm Dick Mott of the Dallas Mavericks. One of our favorite plays over the years has been a play that is quite active as far as total position is concerned. The one guard dribbled down into the attack area, passed to the forward, foul line extended, and make a cut off of the center and establishes a position asking for the ball on the low post.
Against the Lakers, the one guard, Rolando Blackman, passes to Sam Perkins and then slides by center Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. This simple give and go is Dallas's initial option.
If he's not open right away, the center clears himself to receive the pass from the forward. And anytime we pass in this direction, we try to set a screen down on the baseline.
Off the wing, forward Sam Perkins sets a pick.
The one guard can pop in or out, come off of that for a curl and a jump shot or a slip inside. The center has the option to sneak or to pass to the forward on the curl. If that's covered, we always try to have some type of weak side action to occupy the defense. The forward can come up and set a back pick for the off guard, and we can get this type of action where after the screen, you can roll and receive another pass or pop over into the corner for a jump shot.
For 14 demanding seasons, Nate Thurmond played head-to-head with the greatest centers ever to play basketball. And nobody played them tougher than the quiet giant from Bowling Green. 7 times an All-Star, 5 times named to the NBA top defensive team. Night after night, Nate waged battles on the boards. A steady scorer, Nate's forte was defense, grabbing over 15 rebounds a game and earning the admiration of his opponents in an era of NBA legends.
Timing is of essence in everything. When I first started playing, there were 2 guys that were wearing beards, Bill Russell and Will Chamberlain. They were giants, they were great, and they commanded all the publicity, and the battle between the 2 of them attracted a lot of attention. It took a little while, and I got a little respect by playing the 2 of them well, and I'm thinking to myself, well, when these guys retire, it'll be my spotlight, and then along comes a guy who doesn't have a beard from UCLA. But I think it was just like I said, it was just a matter of timing, because when I had to, really battle Kareem, I was going downhill a little bit. I was fortunate enough to be able to play him well from using my head. But at that time, my skills were, eroding. So it was just, somebody else who was just a little bit better, and I'll say that, a little better came in at my time or before me, and it just kept me kind of, in the background.
In the background, only in the minds of the media, because the best big men in the game remember Nate well.
Well, Nate Thurmond guarded me the toughest. He was tall and agile and quick and aggressive. I guess he played center like a linebacker, kind of. He was an excellent defender.
Something that was a highlight to me personally was we went to 6 games with Milwaukee. When I got through playing that 6 games in Milwaukee, 11,000 people stood up and applauded the way that I had played Kareem for those 6 games. That was one of the greatest things that ever happened to me. To have that happen to you in a foreign place, and especially when you're playing against a guy that they have with the caliber of Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, that was definitely a highlight in my career personally.
Retired in 77, Nate now works in the Warriors' front office, enthusiastically promoting the game he loves.
If you think about a professional basketball player who is usually somebody who is extremely tall, or at least taller than the average person, doing things with their body that the average person does not dream about doing, I think that this is what sets aside professional basketball from any other sport. We have guys in this league who are bulky, who are tall, and they do ballets. I mean, they just dance without music out there. I was always, so to speak, the kind of, center point on my team. I was a big guy, that was a good player. And guys, you know, respected me. And I was always an easy, nice guy to get along with. And I was always that way because, you know, life is fun. I mean, you know, basketball was fun.
I'm not from this planet. I'm from the planet Lovetron. I'm from the planet Lovetron. Chris Webber got to be from Chocolate Paradise. When I played, I wanted to dunk on everybody.